Welcome dear students, in this online lecture we are going to know how to solve a projections of solids problem when the solid is resting on HP and its axis is parallel to VP and inclined to HP. Already two problems we solved in this contest and now one more problem we are going to solve in that. So this problem is in our problem set number 3. A hexagonal prism of base side 30 mm and axis 60 mm is resting on HP on one base corner such that the axis is parallel to VP and 30 degree to HP. So this problem is coming under solid axis inclined to HP and parallel to VP. Let's go and solve the problem. Here, this is what the question: hexagonal prism with the base side 30 mm and axis height 60 mm are given, and this solid is resting on HP on one base corner. Okay, and the axis is parallel to VP and 30 degree to HP. So, very first, we need to start the problem with our XY line. Let me to draw the XY line. And then after this, the very first thing we need to finalize is where to start the answer, whether from the top view or from the front view. Always in this projections of solids problem, we have to start the answer by drawing the base view of the solid. So here the solid is a hexagonal prism. So the base of the solid is a hexagon. That hexagonal base should be drawn first, and in particular in which view this has to be drawn, whether in front view or in top view, that depends on the solid's resting condition. Here actually the solid is resting on horizontal plane with one of its base corner and the axis is inclined to HP and parallel to VP. So in this way the solid's future alignment will be like that. So the axis is inclined to HP and parallel to VP. So in that case, as per our instructions given in the last problem, we need to make the solid's axis perpendicular to HP and parallel to VP. It is very easier to make the axis parallel to perpendicular to HP instead of making it parallel to VP, in order to see the base view of the solid in any one of the view. If you make the axis of the solid perpendicular to HP, that is, if you tilt the solid to be resting on HP by its base, you can see the base of the solid from the top. So you can get the base view in the top view. So in this problem, the solid's base view hexagon can be drawn in the top view. So the answer can be start from the top view. And the meantime, this is so far we finalized where will be the base, and then you have to finalize how to draw the hexagonal base, because the hexagonal base can be drawn like that or like that or like that also. Any alignment is possible, but the choice 1, 2, 3, which one is correct for the current situation, that's based on the condition given in the problem. Actually the solid is resting on HP on one base corner. This is the point we need to highlight. It's going to rest on HP by one of its base corner. So you have to predict the choice 1, choice 2, choice 3. In which choice, if you draw the solid further, then at the stage 3, if you tilt the solid in order to make the axis inclined at 30 degree to HP, for example, if the first choice, if you tilt this solid inclined to HP, definitely one of its base edge will going to rest on HP. But in the choice 2, if you tilt the solid in the third stage, you can make one base corner will rest on HP. So in this problem you have to select the second choice. The third choice also will serve the same result for the current need. However, we can draw in this way in order to enjoy some graphical advantages during the drawing of the solid. Okay, visible, invisible, hidden edges works will be reduced when you select the second choice. So we can, until otherwise there is any no specific conditions given in the problem for the inclination of any base side with respect to VP or anything else, we can select the second choice in order to continue the problem. Now let me to draw a hexagonal base in the top view. Now it's actually a hexagonal prism, so it's having base corners as well as face corners, so you need to name totally 12 number of corners. Before that, we can find out the center point of the solid by connecting the opposite corners in the hexagonal face. So roughly I can mark the center here, and the base corners can be named with alphabets, and the face corners can be named with numerals. Since the base corners are hidden behind the face corners, when you look from the top, I am just putting bracket around the base corners, and then we need to project each and every corner towards the front view. Including the center point in order to locate the axis in the lateral view of the solid in front. Okay, now I have completed the base view, and now I need to proceed to the lateral view. In order to draw the lateral view, first you have to finally set the axis height of the solid. It's given in the problem as 60 mm. We can draw the lateral view of the solid. and the access line is also need to be highlighted with the access line format. We have to use the dashed dotted line format for highlighting the axis, and we need to mention the various corners in the solid. Starting from A dash, B dash, F dash, here C dash, E dash, and D dash. In the face 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 5 dash, and 6 dash. Yes. And now we have completed the simple projection of the solid. Then you need to draw the second level, that is the now the axis of the solid is perpendicular to HP and incline parallel to VP. You have to make the axis inclined to HP and parallel to VP by redrawing this lateral view once again. Before that, you have to draw a pilot line here with 30 degree inclination with HP. Then we need to redraw this lateral view once again. Made the lateral view with the axis inclined at 30 degree to the horizontal plane. Now you need to project each and every corner in the solid towards the top view. And then project us from the previous top view. Now it's time to mark the cut points. Starting from the base corners A, B, C, D, E, and F. And for the face corners, the point 1 is here, 1 dash is there. So projector of 1 dash, projector of 1, both will intersect at this point we can log the point 1 finally. And similarly for the point 2 and the 2 dash, both projectors will come and intersect at this point, so we need to log the point 2 here. The same way we can mark point 3, point 4, point 5, point 6. For your understand purpose only, I am making points in the intersections of the projectors, but in your drawing you need not to mark the point in some bigger manner. This will affect the appearance of the drawing, just remember. And then based on the three stages rule, we can join the visible and invisible edges. Before that, we have to have the list of various edges in the base, inside and in face. In the base we are having the edge AB, BC, CD, DE, EF and FA. Totally 6 edges are there. And in the face 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 6 and 6, 1. In the face 1A, 2B, 3C, 4D, 5E and 6F. So totally this solid is having 18 edges. 18 edges. All these 18 edges to be joined now. So by following the simple rules, four stages rule, first you have to join, as per the first rule, you have to join all outermost corners as visible edges. Let me to join the outermost corners are first joined as visible edges. So after followed this step, you need to identify what are all the edges now joined. In the base side, the edge AB, the edge BC and the edge EF and the edge FA are get joined. So we need to rub off those edges. In our list. And the same way in the face edge, the edge 2, 3, the edge 2, 3, the edge 3, 4, the edge 4, 5 and the edge 5, 6 are get joined. And in the case of the side edges, the edge 1A is not yet joined, the edge 2B and the edge 6E, sorry, the edge 2B and the edge 3C and the edge 5E and the edge 6F are get joined. Only the edges 1A and 4D are not yet joined. So after following the first rule, most of the edges are get joined. And then the second rule is you have to join all remaining face corners as visible edges. So the remaining face edges are 1, 2 and 6, 1. These two edges are to be joined as visible edges. The edge 1, 6 and the edge 1, 2. Yes. These two edges are get joined. And just rubbing them off. Yes. Now the third rule is join all remaining base corners as invisible edges. So the remaining base corners are CD and DE. These two edges to be highlighted as invisible edges because they are not visible when you see the solid from the top. So the edge CD and DE, the edge CD and DE to be joined as invisible edges. So I need to follow the dashed line format for drawing these two edges, the edge CD and DE. Yes. These two edges get connected and now the last step is you have to finalize the visible or invisible status of the lateral edges, simplifying the objects from the top view. When you see this object from the top, you can easily decide the edge 1A is visible or not visible. It's simply visible. So you need to join it as visible edge. The edge 1A is a visible edge. Yes. And the 1A's work is over. And about the edge 4D. The edge 4D is when you see the solid from the top, see the solid from the top, the edge 4D is invisible edge because it's just under the solid and it's a not a visible edge, it's an invisible edge. So you have to highlight the edge 4D as an invisible edge in the current top view. And one more thing, here you need to note one point. The edge 4D, the edge 4D is we are going to connect as invisible edge, but the span of partially the span of 4D is covered by the visible edge 1A. You can look here, the edge 1A, a visible edge, covered the partial span of the edge 4D. So you should not rub off this visible edge and highlight the span between D and 4 as invisible edge. In our graphical rule, we need to give higher priority to the visible edges only and next priority to the invisible edges. So here the edge 1A is visible edge, the edge 4D is invisible edge. So in that case, you need to give higher priority to the edge 1A and lesser priority to the edge 4D in order to show its original view. So you need to mark the invisible edge 4D up to the uncovered area by the edge 1A. Now the work is over. This is nothing but the problem given. We just drawn a hexagonal prism of base side 30 mm, axis height 60 mm, resting on HP by one of its base corners and the axis is inclined at 30 degree to HP. So practice this problem with your tools, your paper, and complete your learning. Thank you very much.